men, 20 men, 30 men.
I'm on something.
10 men, 20 men, 30 men.
That bag coming.
10 men, 20 men, 30 men.
You know what's up.
10 men, 20 men, 30 men.
Yeah, trick them up.
This is my favorite part of the show. I got a simple question for you. It's a yes or no answer. Can you rap?
Yeah.
Yeah. You can rap?
Yeah.
You sure you can rap? I'm talking about gifts.
Nah, I mean,
I'm fucking with you.
I mean, I can do it. I can put my mind to it.
You can put your mind to it. All right, so listen. With that being said, I don't know if you ever saw my show before, but I have this segment on the show. It's called On The Spot. You know what that means?
Yeah. I'm not on the spot freestyler, though.
Listen.
Yeah.
That means you're on the spot. You don't got a freestyle.
Yeah.
See, that's the misconception. You know what a freestyle is? Freestyle is something off the top of the head.
Yeah.
You're making it as you go. You don't got to do that. But what we need you to do, we need to hear some type of lyrical content from you. Some bars, whatever. It could be a song. It could be that go-to rhyme you have.
Yeah.
It could be whatever. Yeah. Whatever you want niggas to hear. You know what I'm saying? Whatever is representative of you. You know what I'm saying? Because this is your business card right here. People see this. It's when people want to fuck with you. You know, you got to talk to the people. Yeah. Memphis watching.
Yeah.
I'm watching.
M-Town.
You know, what part of Memphis you from exactly?
I'm from Herbury, baby. Herbury, Tennessee.
There it is, man. Everybody watching you and they root for you, man. You can't let them down.
Yeah, but
let's see what you got, man. Let's go. It's the Jigginator, man.
Yeah, we in the beard.
This is 50, man. Let's go. This is what I do, man. I bring you hot, up-and-coming talent, man. Let's go.
I'm gonna start off like this.
Do it.
I ain't never lied, it's a lot of niggas out here playing both sides. Yeah, I stayed down, had to run it up. Yeah, I waited on my time. A lot of niggas, they didn't like that. Didn't like the fact that I fight back. Took some time out the game for a minute, then a nigga came right back. You hear me?
Just something simple, so you can give him a little jab, a little Mike Tyson uppercut, and all right, that's what it is. That's dope. You know what it is, man. DJ Thorough, AKA Thorough Zano, the bridge to the streets. Right now, you're watching The Hottest in the Streets. Right here on thisis50.com. You know what it is, man. Like always, got a special guest in the building. Introduce yourself.
Yeah, I go by the name of Jigginator himself. Straight out of M-Town. You know what's going on. I'm the hottest thing in the streets right now. You know, I've got a mixtape coming out. It's about to be epic, man. I'm looking at Memorial Day weekend. So y'all get ready to tune in. I got that hot single out right now. Two Sides on Worldstar. Go check that out.
Right. Now, where'd you get that name from? Is it Jigginator?
Yeah. It's called Jigginator.
I like that name. Where'd you get that from?
Actually, it's kind of crazy because the way I came up with the method, you know, I used to play Call of Duty a lot.
Okay.
So, you know, it's a boss on there called the Juggernaut.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? And what I do, you know what I'm saying? I'm in the streets, you know what I'm saying? So my money flow, like, never stops. You know what I'm saying? It's like a generator that continues to go.
Okay.
So I took that, like, this dude can't be defeated and they can't stop me from doing what I do.
Right.
So I just combined those together, you know, came up with Jigginator.
Jigginator.
And I just couldn't leave it at that. I was like, it's just me in the flesh, so himself, you know.
Okay, so you're coming out of Memphis.
Yeah.
Memphis, Tennessee. I have a lot of love for Memphis, man. It's a lot of deep, rich music history in Memphis.
Yeah.
Let's test your knowledge real quick. Name me two famous rappers or rap groups from Memphis.
That's easy, man.
Hey, if it's easy, it's just
3-6 Mafia and CMG.
And CMG, okay. Who's the king of Memphis?
I'm the king of Memphis.
You're the king?
I'm soon to be the king.
You're soon to be the king.
Yeah, but man, my honest opinion, man, I probably had to give it to Gotti, man.
You had to give it to Gotti.
Yeah, I had to give it to Gotti. Because he's been around, been in the game a long time, seeing where he came from and where he at now. So, I had to get to Gotti.
Now, I'm not from Memphis, but from what I hear, there's a lot of division in Memphis. Like, a lot of hate going on where people artists don't like to help each other.
Yeah, it's a lot.
Is that still going on, and why is that?
Yeah, actually, it's still going on right to this day because another artist don't want to see another one outdo him.
Okay.
You know, it's like, I currently just went in. I'm going through a situation like that right now.
Okay.
With one of my homeboys, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
We did a song together when I got out. It was a hot song, you know. A couple people saying I killed them on it.
Right.
You know, just joking, you know. But at the same time, he should have took that in consideration and stepped his game up.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? But I'm going through that now. But I ain't with that beefing.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? I don't do that. That's rap beef. I don't do that.
Right. So at the end of the day, it's competition, but they're taking it too far.
Exactly.
It turns to the point where nobody wants to help anybody.
Exactly. And, basically, everybody out for themselves.
Everybody out for themselves.
If Memphis come together like Atlanta, we'd be the hottest city We'd be the hottest thing in the U.S.
Memphis got talent. Memphis got a lot of talent. Like, I always had a lot of respect for Memphis and the artists there. Like, we got a lot of talent. Even before rap, you know? You know, so Memphis is definitely on the map when you talk about music, historically anyway, period. Before hip-hop even started, then Memphis been doing their thing. So.
Yeah.
But let's talk about you. What you got out today? What we promoting?
Right now, I got just my single out called Two Sides. You know, I got just dropped that video on Worldstar.
Okay.
You know, it's... hit 1 million in 5 days.
Okay.
So
them boys getting money over there. Okay.
Yeah, we doing all right.
I need a job, man.
You need a job, come on to Memphis, I got you. But hopefully I'll be dropping my mixtape soon, man.
Right.
Real soon. I'm looking at Memorial Day weekend though.
Right.
In May.
All right. So listen, so with so many artists out, what are you doing different to stand out instead of fitting in? Because we got so many artists.
Yeah.
And basically everybody's talking about the same shit. Are you doing anything differently? Or?
Yeah. What I got different that I bring to the game, not only that my voice stand out alone by itself,
mm-hmm.
but everything I'm talking about is the truth. Like, I'm speaking facts.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? Ain't none I'm doing is a lie.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? And my knowledge to the streets is going to bring them together. You know
right.
what I'm saying? Like, it ain't going to have them separate. Like, that separation, that shit over with. That
right.
shit get old. You know what I'm saying? So,
right. All right. So you kicking street knowledge.
Yeah.
And you kicking street shit.
Yeah.
For street niggas. That's your lane.
Yeah.
Right. So other than that, musically, do you dabble in other areas, the concepts, like maybe like you got records with females, you turn
yeah.
it up, you got black shit. I don't know. Wait,
you know
you
I
at?
Got club bangers.
Uh-huh.
You know I got a couple of R&B things for the women. You know, I got a couple of things for the kids. You know what I'm saying?
You gotta reach out to the kids. That's rare.
If you win the kids over, you win the game.
That's true. So, I didn't even think about that.
That's pretty much what I got going on. I got a real movement going on. I'm trying to build right now, man. So
right. All right. So any visuals, like if they wanted to get their first impression of Jigginator,
yeah.
And you said go to YouTube and look at this. What would that be? What do you want them to see? The first impression of you? What video?
My first impression, I say go to YouTube. And watch that Two Sides right now.
Okay, Two Sides.
Yeah,
explain Two Sides. That. Explain that video.
The concept. The concept of the video, where the song is basically is a lot of hate. You know,
okay.
I'm from a city where it's a lot of hate, and no matter how much you hard you work, no matter how much you help somebody, they still gonna turn their back on you.
Right.
Try to cross you out.
Right.
So, and these are true facts. Like, I done been through these situations. So.
Right. Right. I feel you. So growing up in Memphis, who were some of the artists you were listening to? Like, how did you get into hip hop? What group or what artist inspired you to say, hey, you know what, I can do this rap shit?
Well, I actually started trying to do it like about 1.5 years ago.
Okay, damn, you new to this.
Yeah,
okay.
So, but it sounds like I've been in the game about 10 years. So.
Okay.
But who I grew up listening to, I only listen to one artist.
Who's that?
And that's Jeezy.
You know, so okay.
That's the only person I'm gonna be able to. If he Jeezy. Come with me with a check, I'm gone.
Jeezy.
I'm gone.
All right.
But I grew up listening to Jeezy. But I messed with A-Ball, MJG. You know, I had to show me some love too.
Right.
Gotti. You know, Plies when he was hot, you know.
Right.
Fat Trail, you know, people like that. But Jeezy, I had to, you know,
Jeezy.
That's my main focus.
That's your main focus.
Yeah.
Right. All right. So. Let me ask you this question. Where do you see yourself in 5 years? Like, where are you looking to get out of this rap game?
Five years from now?
Right.
I'm looking to be at a level where nobody else had been at a level.
Okay.
Like, I want to out top. I'm not trying to be the fastest, get to the point as fast as anybody else. I'm the slower my grind, the more I work to it,
right.
the more I'm going to appreciate it.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? 5 years from now, I'm looking to be the hottest thing.
I'm looking to be the hottest.
To ever be in the music game.
Right. Okay. Check this out. If there was no money in this music business, if you just had to do it for the passion of it, would you be doing this?
Yeah, I would.
You would?
Yeah.
Okay.
Because I love doing it.
Okay.
You know, if the money ain't involved now.
Right.
So, I mean, the reason why
I ask you that, a lot of artists, they're only doing this because there's a financial gain that you could possibly get. They're not really into music.
Yeah.
It's just a hustle, another hustle for them. And those type of artists usually don't last long.
Yeah. See, you know? I just get it. What motivates me, I was just at Black Beach. And the crowd, they had a concert there.
Okay.
They were sold out. When no artist got to hit the stage, the reaction they were giving off, the feedback,
right.
that was beautiful to me. Like, That's what I want.
That's what you want.
I can care less about the money. Like, I just want to have somebody who I'm motivating.
Right.
You know, somebody that can, you know what I'm saying, walk my footsteps and right. see where I'm coming from. You know what I'm saying?
Right. Well, you're definitely motivating somebody right now, because there's somebody from your hometown right now looking at this shit.
Yeah.
Going, damn, this nigga left Memphis and went to New York and he's making moves. So you yeah. are motivating somebody somewhere. You know?
Yeah.
So keep doing your thing. I definitely commend you on that. Definitely. Yeah. Definitely. Like, if somebody wanted to get in contact with you or follow you, how can they do that?
Man, you can follow me on Instagram, at Juggernator himself, Snapchat, Juggernator himself, Twitter, Nader Mode, you Facebook, Juggernator himself, Nader Mode, right. however you want to find me. That's how you can right. find me.
So other than the Two-Face song on YouTube, what else we got coming out?
I'll be shooting a video soon.
In New York, he's shooting a
yeah,
video. You're
gonna
see
video
me in that
here
too,
today.
Man. I'm gonna
you know
be in that
saying?
Shit too, because I fucks with Memphis, man.
Yeah.
When I come out there, man, yeah, show me love, man, as I fuck with y'all, man.
Yeah.
For real, and take me to Rendezvous, even though my man said that ain't the best barbecue spot.
Yeah.
What's the best barbecue spot?
Interstate.
I'm in Interstate, man. That's what yeah. we doing, man.
But I'm shooting a video today, man, here in New York.
Exactly.
It's called Out of Here.
Because yeah, he's out of here.
No, I'm out of here.
Out of here. All right.
You smell me.
If you want to talk to him, you got to call me first.
Because they know?
Because he's out of here.
Yeah.
Exactly. He's out of here. Word. So before we get out of here, man, is there anything you want to cover that we didn't cover or talk about?
Other
than people know.
Much, we pretty much got everything.
Yeah?
Yeah.
What's up with you?
I always keep your family first, man. No matter what you're going through, no matter how time right. hard get. My mama, the love of my life. I just want to say that.
Oh, man. All right, so that's what it is, man. The Juggernator, man. Memphis, Tennessee, man. I fuck with y'all, man. You know what it is, man. DJ Thorough. It's the hottest in the streets. This is 50.com. And like always, when you see us, we're near us. Let me pay respects. We out. Yeah.